Hello and welcome to TI Precision Labs. In this video, we're going to discuss a key electrical measurement in high-speed signaling environments, the eye diagram. Eye diagrams can be useful when evaluating, designing, and debugging your system. In this first session, we're going to discuss the fundamental elements of eye diagrams, eye diagram anatomy, and different measurements that can be made from an eye diagram. Then we will discuss the practical implications of eye diagrams from different perspectives. In future sessions, we will discuss specific forms of disturbance and equalization and how these can be identified in eye diagrams. In order to begin the discussion on eye diagrams, we must first understand what is an eye diagram. Simply put, an eye diagram is a data-dependent electrical measurement used to evaluate high-speed data quality. An eye diagram is measured in the time domain, and as with most time domain electrical measurements, variation in the measurement will occur in every set of samples. By collecting these variations in the signal, more information about system performance can be determined. An eye diagram is constructed in this way, which we will discuss later. Eye diagrams are commonly used when simulating systems, evaluating products, and debugging system-level issues. Generally, these systems contain a high-speed data link such as USB, DisplayPort, HDMI, Ethernet, and many more. Now that we understand what an eye diagram is, let's discuss how this measurement may be useful to us. Eye diagrams do not show any specific detail on the protocol level, but can be useful in determining the cause of data-related failure from an electrical perspective. They help to uncover the underlying cause of system problems such as bit errors, lost data packets, incorrect receiver termination, and others. In addition, most high-speed differential signaling protocols use eye diagram tests to evaluate signal quality and confirm that the signal meets specific standards as defined by an eye mask. This makes eye diagrams a necessity when designing systems that use high-speed signaling protocols. As an example, look towards the top of the slide. This eye diagram clearly shows that there is a high amount of loss in the high-speed signaling environment. This causes the center portion of the eye diagram, generally referred to as the eye opening, to be closed. This indicates that the system has poor signal quality and likely a high bit error rate. In the second image, the same eye opening is opened by introducing a high-speed signal conditioner. This allows the signal to pass the eye diagram test and achieve an acceptable level of signal performance and bit error rate. If you've seen an eye diagram before, you're familiar with the image on the top right. However, how does an oscilloscope construct an eye diagram? As mentioned previously, an eye diagram is measured in the time domain, and variation in the measurements will occur with every set of samples. On the left, you can see various waveforms that can be transmitted through the transmission media in a high-speed signaling environment and measured by an oscilloscope. The oscilloscope will capture these waveforms and overlay them on top of each other, each sample period, to create an eye diagram. This variation is captured over multiple unit intervals, or UI. A UI is the amount of time required for two consecutive transitions to occur. It's also called the pulse time. By collecting many different bit transitions, large amounts of information about electrical signal and how it propagates through the transmission media can be collected. Eye diagrams should be taken over many samples to ensure the eye diagram truly represents system performance. Pseudo-random bit sequence patterns are commonly used to generate eye diagrams. In the figure shown, we see a simple representation of an eye diagram. Let's discuss the fundamental parts of an eye diagram to help further future discussions. VH in red and VL in blue are two fundamental components of an eye diagram. These two features of an eye diagram indicate if the receiver will see the expected voltage levels corresponding to the correct bit. VH should correspond to a 1, while VL should correspond to a 0. These voltage levels are typically described in the electrical specification of the transmitter. The three lines shown in green represent a bit transition. Because the transition occurs on the left side of the eye diagram, it's commonly called the leading edge. Conversely, the bit transitions which occur on the right side are called trailing edge. These bit transitions contain the high frequency content of the signal. When analyzing the eye diagram, the leading and trailing edge will show the effects of different types of equalization, as well as the effects of different types of transmission media loading. The crossover region is another important part of the eye diagram. The crossover regions can show variation in the bit transitions, commonly known as jitter, and normally indicates the widest part of the eye diagram. This is important in understanding the effects of the total jitter of the system. Two of the most commonly used vertical measurements of an eye diagram are eye height and eye amplitude. These two measurements are similar but describe slightly different things. Eye amplitude describes the overall peak-to-peak voltage of a high-speed signal. When implementing high-speed data protocols, such as USB, PCIe, FPD link, etc., the peak-to-peak voltage, or eye amplitude, is firmly defined. The eye height is a measure of the voltage difference between the lowest measured VH and the highest measured VL. It refers to how open the eye diagram of your system is. Eye height and eye amplitude values are similar for very open eyes. However, for eye diagrams with a small eye, there will be a significant difference. Generally, the primary cause of low eye height is the insertion loss of the transmission media. There are also several key horizontal measurements that can be made with an eye diagram. Eye width is the most important of these measurements. This measurement is normally taken at the widest part of the eye. Achieving a specific eye width is critical in passing an eye diagram test. Eye width indicates how open an eye diagram is from a timing perspective. Total jitter can be measured for the eye diagram and decomposed into its fundamental components by the oscilloscope. As total jitter increases, the available eye width of your signal decreases and affects how the receiver samples the transmitted data. Systems with large amounts of total jitter tend to have poor signal quality and a higher bit error rate due to the smaller eye opening. Edge rate can also be extracted from the eye diagram and can be useful in determining specific effects that may affect the crossover region. Edge rate can also be another parameter tested for when implementing some high-speed data protocols to ensure proper transmitter performance. For the diagram on this slide, the edge rate is measured beginning at the 90% and 10% voltage levels. Depending on the specification, the edge rate can be measured in slightly different ways, such as at the 80% and 20% voltage levels, or the 70% and 30% voltage levels. In previous slides, we have discussed eye diagram tests. A key component of an eye diagram test is the eye mask. An eye mask represents different key diagram requirements and is a predefined region made up of six key points which define a minimum eye opening, maximum DC high region, and a minimum DC low region. An eye mask can be thought of as a keep-out region. When the oscilloscope samples a point inside the keep-out region defined by the eye mask, this is known as an eye mask violation. Passing an eye diagram test means that your system must have no eye mask violations. This is critical to be compliant to many high-speed data protocols. In some cases, in order to pass eye diagram testing, a high-speed signal conditioner must be used to clean the signal to ensure that it does not violate the eye mask. When no eye mask violations are present, an acceptable level of signal performance has been achieved. There is a wealth of information that can be drawn from an eye diagram. However, how you interpret this information depends on what kind of device is being tested. Next, we'll discuss some practical implications of an eye diagram from three different perspectives. When evaluating transmitter performance for a high-speed data link, you want to ensure your test setup is such that the transmitter is as close to the oscilloscope as possible. This allows you to see the transmitter performance without any effects from cabling or the PCB trace. This allows you to see the realistic transmitter performance under ideal conditions without outside influence. Key electrical parameters that can be verified from an eye diagram are the VH, VL, peak-to-peak voltage, any pre-emphasis or de-emphasis added to the signal. Edge rates, and any deterministic jitter generated by the transmitter being tested. Verifying that the transmitter is behaving as expected can help with both evaluation of different products and determining if signal conditioning is needed. In the eye above, you can see an example of a transmitter eye and the different measurements that can be taken. As with transmitters, eye diagrams when measured at the receiver can have their own meaning. High-speed data receivers are designed such that they sample at the most open part of an eye diagram for a given data rate. In the above image, you can see a typical sampling region. Sampling inside this region ensures that the correct bit is sampled without interference from the neighboring bits. Sampling outside this region could mean that the receiver interprets errors in the data. There is no coincidence that the sampling region overlaps with where the eye mask is overlaid on the eye diagram test. When evaluating a particular receiver, it is important to have the signal source close to the receiver to avoid adding additional losses due to the transmission media and probe loading. Sometimes it is not possible to compensate for all the loading effects and losses inherent to the test setup, and this can be reflected in the eye diagram above. It is important to take into account these effects when evaluating a specific receiver. Understanding receiver performance for a given input is very important when designing your system. Whether this means testing the receiver's equalization scheme, internal termination loading effects, noise immunity, or jitter tolerance, measuring the eye diagram can prove useful in understanding how your receiver interacts with specific input signals. Measuring eye diagrams from a system perspective can be very complicated. The interaction between the transmitter and the receiver can be influenced by transmission media, other components located in the signal path, such as ESD devices, and many different external noise sources. Measurements should be taken at different points in the system to further the debug process. Eye diagrams can help in the debug process by identifying key signal integrity concepts that enhance or degrade system-level performance. Concepts such as receiver equalization, transmit pre- and de-emphasis, inter-symbol interference, and reflections caused by sudden impedance change can all be identified and measured in an eye diagram. To refresh your mind on what we discussed, let's go over a short quiz. Check all correct statements. A. Eye diagrams are an electrical measurement that is not data dependent. B. Adding high-speed signal conditioners can improve an eye diagram. C. Eye diagrams are constructed by overlaying different bit transitions over time. D. Eye diagrams only contain vertical measurements. The correct answer is B and C. Check all correct statements. A. Eye diagrams contain trailing and leading edges. B. Eye diagrams can be verified with an eye mask. C. Random jitter can be measured from an eye diagram. D. Edge rate can be measured from an eye diagram. The correct answer is B, C, and D. True or false? Eye diagrams can only contain two discrete DC voltage levels. The correct answer is false. In summary, eye diagrams are a common and useful tool to evaluate the high-speed signal quality of a system. In future videos, we will discuss how certain signal integrity issues affect eye diagrams, how these issues can be identified, and how they impact system-level performance. Thanks for watching.